Today's subject is comparison, the Egypt history and Exodus. The First Kings chapter 14, 25 and Second Chronicle 12, 2. It said, in the fifth year of King Rehoboam, Shishak, king of Egypt, attacked Jerusalem. Now, this fact is also written in Egypt history. When Napoleon discovered the Valley of Kings, and there's many written thing there, and then this one is matched to the Israel Kings and the Chronicle. Now today's I want to compare that Exodus and the Egypt history. Before Moses left, Egypt, he made 10 miracles. It's 10 plagues to Egypt. The Nile River turned red, then all the frogs came out, then lice is all over the places and fly all over the places. And at the end, then, sun become dark. Many people interpret that, Egypt, worship the sun as a god. And then, meaning that, Jehovah God, destroyed Egypt, a god. On the top of that, at the time, Exodus chapter 10, verse 7, Pharaoh's official said to Pharaoh that, how long will this man be snare to us? Let the people go so that they may worship the Lord their God. Do you not yet realize that Egypt is ruined? Then after that, the all the first son of each family are killed. This is disaster to Egypt. And after that, 600,000 men, get out of the Egypt, crossing Red Sea. So not only there must be family that they believe that almost 2 million people in there. However, that when Israel left Egypt, it is great loss to Egypt. And we understood that all these ones are written by Moses, because Moses was escaped by the princess of Egypt, and Moses got the train and education in Egypt. Unfortunately, so far there is no archaeological evidence all those 10 plagues and crossed over the Red Sea. There's no written record. And even though name of Moses is not written in Egypt history, only Exodus. Now, when I talk to you know, friend in here, that you know, some you know, rabbi or Jewish people, they knew that there is no history written about Exodus. Let's go to a little more story. In 1965, there is a war between Israel and Arab Union. At the time, it lasted in 6 days only. Israel was a strong country at the time and defeated all Arab nations. Until 1978, that Israel returned back to Sinai Peninsula to Egypt. In the meantime, almost like, you know, 14 years, that the Israel archaeologists tried to discover all the route written in Exodus around, you know, Sinai, you know, Peninsula. Especially, they look at, you know, God's banner, which is Israel people, you know, stay for longest period over there. And unfortunately, they could not find any archaeological, you know, evidence at all. Now, according to Exodus chapter 1, verse 11, they built Pithom and Rameses as store cities for Pharaoh. Now, this, you know, Rameses is Ramses II. The period at the time is BC around 1250. And we know that, you know, Moses was born, and then maybe, you know, they left, you know, about 1450 BC. Then this one is Moses wrote 200 years later thing. This doesn't match each other historically. No, not way, no way. So the old historical evidence and, you know, Exodus and all biblical, you know, figuration doesn't match each other. Now, there are some similar story, like, Ten Plague in Egypt, called Ipu, that's a papyrus. So if you are interested, you look it up. Now, according to this one, there is a similar story like a 10th plague, that the first son killed, Nile River turned red, you know, things like that. But this, according to them, the original text could be BC 2300. Now, Moses' story about BC 1500, then, you know, Moses may copy the story of this Ipueru papyrus 800 years before. I made a video already that, you know, Moses could not write the Genesis. Now, based upon all this evidence, Moses could not write Exodus either. So some you know, students go to theoretical, college, learn about this old, Bible story. And then the professor told them, there is no evidence, archaeological evidence, about Moses or Exodus in Egypt or anywhere. And some student, what's wrong with this one? I thought that was a real story, but it was not a real story. And some of them, okay, I don't have to study anymore. They just leave the school. Now, we believe Bible because of all kinds of miracles made by God. But it's just in the Bible. But there is no historical evidence at all whatsoever. Next time, I am going to introduce about Gilgamesh, the flood story. How similar with, Bible story. Thank you so much for your watching.